So Python is in Excel. You've probably seen the headlines. If you haven't spotted that new button in Excel yet, you will soon. But what exactly is it? And more importantly, are you going to need it for your work? So I've made different videos on the how. In this video, let me give you a high-level overview so you can decide if this is going to be your next essential skill. So what is Python in Excel? Python is one of the most popular programming languages in the world. It's used in everything from machine learning to building apps to automating stuff. But here's the thing, in Excel, we're not using it to build apps or websites. We're using it to make data analysis inside Excel more powerful. So you just open your spreadsheet, type in equals py, and you're in Python mode. That means you can combine the flexibility of Python with the structure of Excel. Let me give you a more detailed example of something I created. So here, I wanted to compare two different trading strategies. The one in green is the trading strategy, and the one in blue is just buy and hold the portfolio. So assuming that I invested $1,000 starting from this date, how would those two different portfolios compare with one another? This currently is for Amazon. Let's change it to Microsoft and see what we get. The buy and hold still performs better. What if we started in 2022? Let's see how this updates. Okay, things could be slightly different, right? Let's switch our stock to PepsiCo, for example. How would that look like? Not bad. So here I'm combining Python. This here is Python together with Excel, cell references here. And I'm using the data types feature in Excel, right? So from data types, the stocks feature. And all of this is done here in this cell. So all the Python calculations are here. That's it. If I was going to do this in Excel, it would require lots of helper columns, right? So Python in Excel not only gives us things that we couldn't do before in Excel, but it also makes things that are difficult a lot easier to do. Just to be clear, this is not an add-in. You don't need a separate installation. It's just going to be a part of your ribbon. And you also don't need programming skills. So I don't have a programming background. I was an economist, then worked in finance, and then project management. The cool thing is that you're going to find that Python in Excel looks a lot like writing Excel formulas, right? There's an easy side to it, and there's an advanced side. Just like with Excel formulas, you can have simple formulas, and then you can get all geeky and have very complicated formulas. It's the same in Python, but the easy side will already help you achieve a lot. And there might be a side effect, which happened to me. You might end up loving Python and unwillingly end up with a new valuable skill. So how does Python actually work in Excel? When you enter a Python formula, Excel sends that code to the cloud, specifically to a secure server hosted by Microsoft in partnership with Anaconda. That's why you don't need to install Python, because you're using Microsoft's version. Now, since this is built for data analysis, you can't use it to generate files or control other apps, but you can use it to analyze your spreadsheet's data or connect to external files like CSVs through Power Query. Just a heads up, there is a free version and a premium version. The free version is part of your Microsoft 365 subscription, and it gives you a limited amount of premium compute each month. After that, it can get a bit slower, but totally usable, especially for learning. So if you're getting started, you can absolutely learn Python in Excel with the free version. Next, let's talk about why it's a big deal. Why use Python? So Excel is not going anywhere, and it already gives us a lot of tools, right? We have advanced formulas, pivot tables, charts, Power Query, but we still know it has its limitations, especially when it comes to advanced data analysis. That's where Python fills in the gaps by giving us access to a whole ecosystem that wasn't available to us before. We can use it to create advanced visuals that go way beyond standard Excel charts. We could create proper forecasting models, which is great for finance teams. Machine learning, like clustering data into segments, or spotting anomalies, which is really useful in auditing. If you're using Excel on a very basic level, so let's say you're just using it to input data, this is not for you. But if you're using it for analysis, like data analysis, especially every day, this changes what's possible. What about CoPilot? Yes, you can use AI tools like ChatGPT and CoPilot to help you write your Python code. And most of the time, it's pretty good. So for example, here, I have historical dates and I have my revenue. Let's say I want to do some time series analysis. And I have CoPilot in Excel, so I'm going to click on this icon and get deeper analysis results using Python. So the sidebar pops up and I'll tell it to decompose the time series data. Let's see what we get. I can use advanced analysis for that. Okay, it's understanding the data. Let's wait a little bit. Okay, ready to get started? Yes, start. It inserted a new sheet here. It loaded the data into what is called a data frame, and it's giving us a preview on the sidebar. And it's decomposed it into trend, seasonal, and residual components. Okay, but I want it as a chart. So give me a chart. Let's see what it does. Okay, so now it gave me the trend, seasonal, and residual. And here is the code behind this. Now, I don't know why CoPilot has gone nuts and added all this, because looking at this, you might be like, oh my God, I will never learn Python. But this can actually be written like this. You get all the time series components. We even get one additional chart for the actual values. So AI works, but it's not always perfect and it's not always available. Just this past week, CoPilot kept crashing, ChatGPT ghosted, but your boss probably didn't, your deadlines were still on time. You can't outsource your understanding or your thinking to AI, because otherwise you'll get stuck. Plus, it's really important to understand what's even possible so you know what to ask or how to ask. That's why I created a course that walks you through exactly that. It's called Python in Excel for the Real World. It's designed for Excel people, for you, if you're ready to discover this new side of Excel and pick up a new skill that not so many people in your field have. You can follow along the examples in the course using the free version of Python that comes with your 365 subscription, so you don't need to upgrade for the course. I'm sure you'll love it because you'll discover new options when it comes to advanced data analysis. You'll also learn Python basics so you can confidently tweak the code you get from AI. If you're interested, check out the link in the description of the video. I'd love to show you what's possible and how simple it can be. Thank you for being here, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.